I found that I had quite a good response on my earlier videos, where I say have drawn out a certain circuit. It was a 1-transistor amplifier and a 2-transistor amplifier, and perhaps it's good and interesting to show more in this way. Building up that whole amplifier by drawing it. So in this case it is a 1-transistor. I always hope to say 12 megahertz radio oscillator. And I always hope, like I say, that my camera runs out. I only have 15 minutes. And, well, anyway, 23 May 2021. Well, again, I draw here the positive lead. And I draw again the negative lead. The negative lead is in many cases on the ground, but in the past, say in the 1960s, 70s, where NPN transistors were not common, PNP transistors were common, that meant that the positive was on ground. But regarding, say, the electronics theory, it doesn't matter much on which location the electronic circuit is connected to ground. Could be positive, could be negative, anyway. More common, often common now, 2021, is that we use NPN transistors where the negative is connected to ground. It's an oscillator circuit, so and it works between 2 and 12 megahertz. So that's a radio frequency, and I have by purpose used 2 up to 12 megahertz because that circuit is not very critical. Anyway, we use here again, like in the earlier videos, a resistor and a decoupling unit. I have, say, pointed that out many times. And when we say make a radio oscillator with 1-transistor, that's very important because it strays out radio energy, and that radio energy can, say, travel over the power supply line to other circuits in the radio receiver or whatever. So here again, that resistor, say it's between 50 ohms and 470 ohms. The voltage is between, say, 9 volts and 12 volts. More info in the earlier videos. The smoothing capacitor here, positive minus, is, say, minimum 100 microfarad. The part of the decoupling circuit is here. Say it's again 100 nanofarad, so 0.1 microfarad. And here a, say, 100k resistor or a 470k resistor. Anyway, this is, say, the power supply unit, say 25 volts or 16 volts, that depends, of course, here, 60 volt or 25 volt. You always you have to use a certain margin compared to the power supply voltage and the maximum voltage that the electrolytic capacitor can handle. So, this is the very important part of the circuit. it helps that the oscillator works, etc., etc. And of course, when it's a radio oscillator that has to oscillate on a specific frequency, it's a very good idea to make this voltage stabilized. Every change in the voltage will have an effect on the frequency that the one transistor oscillator strays out. So, use stabilized voltage can be done in the classic way, and when you study my circuits on YouTube and in my books, you will see that I, for instance, used the classical 7812 voltage stabilizer. Sometimes that 7812 stabilizer does not work properly. That has everything to do with the properties of an oscillator. So in that case, you have to use, say, the classical voltage regulator. That's here. Zener diode here. Say 18 volts in, 12 volt Zener. Say 5k resistor could also be 1k, and here a BD139, and here a capacitor, positive minus, say 100 microfarad, here also 100 microfarad. Anyway, it was not the say what I wanted to talk about in this video. I wanted to talk about making that one transistor oscillator, but anyway, stabilized voltage is very important, and these are the pin connections of the BD139 front. So okay, that's good. Many more videos on my YouTube channel. So let's go to the key of this oscillator circuit again. Stabilized voltage, and here we have a transistor. And the good thing of the BC547B is here are the pin connections. The good thing is that this transistor is a so-called MESA transistor. It has extremely good properties, both for audio and high frequencies, and that means that it can work up to maximum, say, 9 megahertz. Here you see 2 up to 12 megahertz. Perhaps it's possible to get it functioning even on that 12 megahertz. Anyway, very, very important is this. Again, we use this bias, and that bias is extremely important. 22k or 25k. That bias is very important because it sets the oscillation. And on the World Wide Web, you find many circuits about radio oscillators, where these resistors are fixed, and that's not a good idea. When you make a radio oscillator, you must be able to set the bias properly, and that bias is very, very critical. Very critical. So here the output capacitor could be 10 picofarad. Here we have the output capacitor of the oscillator, etc. So here we set the bias again with that 1K resistor to prevent that when you move the wiper up to the positive here, the transistor burns out when this resistor is not there. But anyway, so let's look at the more, say, high frequency elements of this circuit, and that is a coil, that's L, and here is that capacitor. This combination sets the frequency. And say for this frequency band, 2 megahertz up to this 12 megahertz, we make use of these kinds of coils. There are many more videos about this on my YouTube. Oh shit, the same happens. Anyways, sorry for that. The same happens. And on my YouTube channel there are much more circuits about how to make that tank circuit. The capacitor and the inductance set the frequency, say with such a coil and a capacitor of say 10 picofarad, 50 picofarad, you go to the say shortwave frequencies. I cannot get into say details about it, but anyway, here there is a coupling capacitor. It depends a lot about how the circuit will work and whether it will work. So you have to do some experiments, and regarding this frequency band, it is between 220 picofarad and say 470 picofarad. That is the coupling capacitor coming out of the tank circuit. Of course, this has also an effect on the frequency, but anyway. So we go here now to the base. So we have here an amplifying element, and the key of say getting this circuit to work is that we need a capacitive voltage divider, and this capacitor must be 4N7. It's a critical value, so 4700 picofarad. And the other capacitor here, this is say more or less fixed. You can use this as a good a base value, so don't change it too much. And here we need a 2K2 resistor, or yes, 2K2 is good. And here we need a resistor, the emitter resistor. And it has to be in the range between 100 ohms and say 470 ohms. And the reason is that in an oscillator circuit, there must be in a certain way, I cannot explain that completely, there must be a kind of current flowing here. And the emitter resistor makes that current flow, and then the other emitter capacitor is also critical, and that has to be between say 100 picofarad and say 1000 picofarad. 1000 pa. That are say all the critical values to make this work, the oscillator work, on frequencies between 2 and 12 megahertz. I have told in earlier videos that the BC547B only works up to 9 megahertz, but it could be that you can get it working on a somewhat higher frequency. Here is the circuit. That's out of my book, Retro Radio. Here the principles are showed again. Etc. Etc. I only have 2 minutes approximately to tell more about the circuit. Well, say kind of spray can falls anyway. This is what I wanted to tell. Decoupling unit, transistor that has to do the job, critical resistor of 4 and 7 that works on this frequency band, and here an experimental capacitor, and the resistor, the emitter resistor, it has to be in the 100 ohms up to 470 ohms range, and then you will surely get it working. Thanks for watching.